not all condos are created equal. And today, we are showing you one of Singapore's best award-winning condominium, and that is Principal Garden. Developed by UOL TOP in 2019, this development has 663 units. Hi guys, Home to Home is back with another property tour, and today we have a top floor one bedroom to show you. Do stay tuned to find out why Principal Garden is so special, and we think you will fall in love with it. Right now we are at the ground level of Principal Garden. So we can see that this ground floor is actually elevated off the surroundings, so we are on a higher ground already. Principal Garden is sitting on a huge plot of land that is over 270,000 square feet. So just to give you an example, for a development to qualify for a condominium status, they need to be at least sitting on the 43,000 square feet of land. So this is 270,000, easily 6 times of the minimum requirement. On top of that, for a development to qualify for condominium, they cannot be taking up more than 40% of the land for the residential blocks. Principal Garden is approximately taking only half of it, which is about 20%. So all these blocks only takes up 20% footprint on the 270,000 square feet of open land. And that gives you an idea of how much openness that you will have in this development. So right now here, we have one pool over in front of block 93 and another pool in the middle and one more at the end. And not just that, on the top floor of block 99, you have a sky pool and another function room. Without further ado, let's take a look at the top floor unit that we are selling today. All right, so welcome to the unit. Here we have a one bedroom, 495 square feet. First off, I want to show you the cabinetry that has been done for you. Right here, of course, your DB box, your shoe cabinet has been done. The developer has also thoughtfully put in your top and bottom cabinets. Right? And here over at the sink, they actually have a cover, so you can have maximized this full tabletop space to work on your meals that when you need to. Right, coming into the unit, the ceiling is high ceiling at over 3 meters height, and you have a width in your living area that is over 3 meters as well. So this is one of the widest living hall that we have seen for a one bedroom unit. So you can see here that we have a 3-seater sofa and a very good distance to your large TV as well. Of course, overlooking this, we are facing southeast. The whole Principal Garden is actually a northwest and southeast orientation. So all the blocks have been thoughtfully placed side by side so that you don't face any neighbors. Of course, being high floor, you can be sure that nobody is looking into the unit as well. So one very important thing is, if you are someone who doesn't like to have some western exposure to the unit, I think the city facing southeast will be perfect for you. Let's take a look at the view. 3 panels of sliding door lets you open up very wide. So as I'm sitting here having my breakfast, I'm actually looking at the MBS, the CBD. So this is city living, right? This is the kind of view that we want. And so of course, right below us is also a park connector. And for cyclists, if you want to cycle to the CBD where you work, it's just under 4.4 kilometers, and that probably take you less than 10 minutes to reach there. So the park connector actually connects you first to Great World City. Some landmarks will be the Clarke Quay and of course the Raffles Place area. I think it's great to have this feature that the park connector is right outside our side gate, which we are facing right now. This development is also situated in a very centralized area where you are very close to the Redhill area. The hawker center for your daily food necessities are right opposite us. 800 meters walk to the Redhill MRT. And if you want to plan an evening dine out, River Valley and the Dempsey area is right behind us as well. So we think that this area is perfectly suitable for young couples or even individuals who enjoy lifestyle living and a very beautiful view. All right, so follow me into the bedroom area right now. For a one bedroom, it is huge. you can have your queen size bed and still a lot of floor space over here. And what I love most is it shares the same view as the living area, giving us the CBD southern view. And it also features a very luxurious bathroom. For those who like marble finishing, this bathroom looks fantastic. And I think most importantly is it has a big window that you can always keep it open for good ventilation. And why I say that you can always keep it open is because you are not facing any neighbors at all. So being on the highest floor, of course, even the opposite buildings are not as tall as you. You have full privacy of what you want to do. All right, let's talk some numbers right now. Today, if you are an investor looking to buy a unit here to rent out, we see from the rental transaction happening this year, it goes as high as $3,000 a month for a one bedroom of this size. Of course, those are of a lower floor as well. So this unit potentially can make you a 3.6% rental yield or slightly more. So assuming you are taking 75% loan and a loan tenure of 30 years, at 1.5% interest rate, your monthly installment will be $2,588. This is what we call a property savings plan. So out of the $3,000 rental that you may receive, $412 will be your passive income. So without taking into consideration of the passive income, for the $2,588, you are actually saving every month. Out of that, $937 is actually the interest paid. Alright, so what we want to see here is $1,651 that is being put into your bank account by the tenancy, and you will be saving that for the next few years that you are holding it. So assuming you are renting this out for the next 10 years, the amount that you will be saving into this property will be $198,000. So let's assume that there's 0% growth to this property value, and 10 years later you are still selling it at $1 million. Your sales proceed after selling it at $1 million and less of your outstanding loan, you will get back $463,000, and that is with an outlay of $250,000. So that is about 85% returns. But assuming there's only 3% growth per annum on this property, the sales proceed will grow to $807,000 for you. So we feel that if you are planning to hold a property for the mid to long term, it's very important to choose the right property that gives you the centralized location, the quality of living, and of course, the good finishings as well. So after 10 years, when all the brand new hype is over, buyers will still be amazed by the quality and the living lifestyle that these developments has to offer. So just drop us a line if you want to come and experience this development yourself. This is Ron from Home to Home, and I'll see you in our next video.